So a lot of our clients are captive finance companies who are looking to grow outside of their base. So for example, they're looking to grow in Europe, they're looking to grow in Asia, and the biggest challenge that they have on hands is, how do I grow fast enough? How do I make sure that I'm not spending my next 18 months just implementing a technology? How do I make sure that I hire the best talent? How do I get my right operating model in place so that I can be closer to the customer and are delivering the product and services that I'm intending to do? So it's always, most of the time, all linked to speed to market and growth. I think a good example I can share with you of a company, you know, who we were working with, this is a large equipment manufacturing company who was looking to expand and set up their base in Europe and in Asia. And for them, the biggest thing was getting close to the customer. And the other big thing for them was to really get to the market. Speed to market for them was of essence. And the third big thing was all about using the most latest and greatest operating models and technologies to really compete with the new age non-lenders. And what they wanted to do was really come up with a model where they could invest a large part of their, what I call as currency, into their front end and really focus on getting a partner who could help them with really a plug and play where they could have a partner, you know, be leveraged for all of servicing. You know, I'm asked several times, so what are the learnings, you know? Where do I start? How should I start? Am I ready? How do I know I'm ready? And really what our learnings have been that the first and foremost in the journey is to look at how is your data today? Because that's really the core, that's really the heart of everything where you start off from. If you don't have good data, it's very difficult to progress into, you know, the future journey of artificial intelligence. So we talk a lot about predictive analytics, we talk a lot about big data, how do you bring that all together so that you can create those insights from that data which is meaningful, which will help future decisioning. And then, you know, take that wheel into using that data to create that corpus which will help the machine to learn from that experience, which can finally be embedded into whether it's natural language processing or natural language generation for artificial intelligence. And that's where the use cases like spreading of financials or mining of your contracts or, you know, doing prospecting using real-time intelligence could all play up very well once you have good, clean data.